Is not in there. It is actually from a symphony. And since we are really coming back in time when we listen to this instrument, it seems to be appropriate to point out that in this minuet, every section is first played forward and then backwards. So I can tell you, I know it backwards. Thank you. So I will play a very, very well-known piece. I hope it will not bring back bad memories of teachers maybe beating your fingers or anything like that. And it's been called Sonata Simply Chin. It's very simple, but actually it is actually complex in its composition, in its form. But it doesn't have any virtuosity. I wanted to give you a hint of what performers at the time would have played before playing a sonata. They would probably not have started a concert the way I did. I thought it was pretty good. Thank you, Lena, for suggesting it. I did. Great. Start a concert, very, very good. But they would improvise. And so Clementi has written a book of preludes in the styles of different composers of the period. And this one is Alla Haydn. And there are things that they knew that they would probably have conversations about or jokes. They would probably be playing on a piano and say, oh, Mozart does this, oh, Haydn does this, and kind of make fun of each other. And so I hope you will see maybe some very long progressions that maybe are making fun of Haydn, liking progressions. And then I will play Mozart. Come. Welcome. I see lots of familiar places. It's great to see you.
Thank you. Thank you. And you as well.
So I don't want to get into historical detail. If you have received an email about this concert, you probably read about this piece with the context when Lafayette was imprisoned. Bombach is not a very well-known composer, and I would probably have never played his music if I had not looked into revolutionary music and Lafayette, of course. We all love Lafayette. So, Le songe de Lafayette.
Lafayette succumbs to the weight of his woes. He no longer finds solace in hope. His imagination creates ghosts that redouble his terrors. Sleep brings him no rest. Dreadful dreams agitate and torment him. His anguish gives way to a welcoming calm. A vision consoles him. His chains are broken. The dark cloud which was enveloping him dissipates. guardian angel of America is standing before him. He sees him. He believes he hears him. Life. His heart opens itself to joy again. Transports him beyond the seas. He sees once more this fortunate island where he had fought for freedom. Boys and girls are dancing to the sound of the flute. They are celebrating at an outdoor festival the sacred love of the nation. Thank you. troops come out of the gates of Boston. They are marching to the sound of trumpets and oboes. They practice during peace in order to be ready against the first sign of danger to the country. Guides him to the temple. There, the assembled people are praising the Most High. They are singing hymns in his honor and thanking him for the ineffable goodness of freedom. Display is followed by a scene of domestic happiness. He sees himself in Washington's arms. Surges. He presses his heart, his family, from whom he has been so long separated. angel reassures and consoles him about the tragedies of France, his homeland. Untangling of chaos on the day of creation, and makes him foresee that it is from within disorder that the order will be reborn. These brilliant dreams have vanished, but with them also the shadow of doubt and sadness that obsessed him has dissipated, and the sweetness of hope has returned to his heart.
In that house for hours just for this piece. I know it's, I usually would never program two pieces in F sharp minor, you know, in a row. It's really bad programming, but actually the theme of this Fantasia by C.P. Bach is the first theme is the same as the one from the Clementi. I think even though that piece, the C.B. Bach was written just a little bit before, it is a little bit more difficult to grasp. It is the most abstract piece in the program. It's challenging to play just mentally because you almost get into a spiral of depression. And it was written just a year before he died, so I don't know much more about the piece, but when I read it, when I must have been 18, I was like, what is this? And I will play this piece, and it's in your program there is only one one movement, but it is a little bit like the Baumbach, a piece that is not like a sonata, it's a fantasia with many movements, but it's many episodes, and you may recognize some themes coming back or some different moods, and I will let you make your own self-narration. Hopefully you will generate some images, suggest some images in your memory.
Thank you.
Now I'm going to play a piece composed by Beethoven in 1789, and we historians know what happened in 1789. And you know, the word the revolution has different meanings. And I believe that this, the prelude I'm about to play, is revolutionary because it goes around the circle of fifths two times. So it goes through all the major keys from C major to C major, back to C major, going to all, and not going up C, G, D, etc. A, and it goes through all the crowd together. So it also is a piece that if you practice for too long will get you dizzy. Spiraling of tonalities. And that will be a prelude to the last piece of the program, which stays in the same key of C major forever. also 12 times, 12 variations. So I've been playing a little bit with numbers in this program. I don't know if you know it, but the Bombach has 13 movements. Apparently, this was a big number. I don't know if you got any Masons in the room. Of course, you would not. And so 13 is a big number. And I think it's a Masonic piece in the temple. But we're back to 12. Okay. So I hope you enjoy this early Beethoven, written when Mozart was still alive. That was interesting. Oh, and by the way, there's something also that reflects back to the Haydn, is that in the theme, I will play for you. And if you play backwards, you go, right? Now, if you put the two together, you get, I mean, if I play there, so forward, backward, together. Thank you.
Thank you.